5 FM, 92.7 FM, and 820 AM as he delivers game changers in Metro RVA. On the Mic with Mike showcases how business can help make society better. He discusses tech, culture, innovation, best business practices, and highlighting area nonprofits. Join Mike at 1 p.m. Monday through Friday, because it is the place where the best and brightest come to chat.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to On the Mic with Mike. It is the leading social enterprise business show here in the Richmond area. I'm your host, Mike King, and I appreciate you being here with me. The views expressed here are mine, have no connection to, support of, or agreement with any other host, information, or ads on the station. I don't work for the station. My program airs here daily, and we appreciate you guys for listening. So join me as this cutting-edge show uplifts the community and showcases RVA in a different way. The sounds you're listening to are emanating from the Mike King Biz Studio. It is the global epicenter of social enterprise business. So join us today as we listen to the sounds provided by the super producer, Al Green, who's on the wheels of steel, and he can be reached by calling 804-778-8888. So On the Mic with Mike highlights partnerships, people, social enterprise business, and organizations and issues of the day. Speaking of issues of the day, we just like to make sure everyone is out there safe and sound during the storm. Make sure you guys are taking care of each other. That's how we do things around here. If you'd like to call us, you can reach us at 804-778-8888. So I'd like to thank our show sponsor, Tom Childry. He is the credit card guy, and he's making a difference out here in the community. He'll be in studio with us tomorrow. And we'll be talking about what he does for the community. If you'd like to find Tom with, as far as credit card processing, we know we have a lot of business owners out there. You can reach Tom by calling 804-503-8472. That's 804-503-8472. So he is providing a lot of quality services to folks and doing a lot of big things as far as nonprofits go. Along the way, folks, we have to pay some bills around here, and so make sure you take a listen to our sponsors. Shout out to Tom. There he is right there in the studio. Maybe he'll drop in for a minute, so make sure you take a listen to the sponsors that we have. I really appreciate them coming on. So today's show, folks, it's an outstanding one. We have with us Dale Fickett of RVA Works. He's going to talk to us in a minute. We also have J.B. Bryant. J.B. Bryant, a lot of folks know her as a financial guru. She's going to be here talking about finances, but also have her opinions and how we deal with people who have differing of opinions. So we're going to have her coming. She's going to give us a call in about a little bit. But without further ado, we have Dale Fickett of RVA Works. Dale, welcome to the program.
Thanks so much, Mike. Great to be here. I love this, Mike on the Mic.
Well, you know, it was original, but it wasn't original. You know, that was, I'd gotten that from the Bad Boys,
right?
A movie, and but it had to add on to RVA because On the Mic with Mike was taken many times over.
Right, and we got Al Green on the wheels of steel.
But
that's the main thing.
There is this show. We spared no expenses.
Right.
We spared no expenses.
Right.
But you're here to talk about RVA Works. Let folks know. Now, I know what you do. A lot of people around town. Let folks know how RVA Works, what it is you do. And a shout out to, you're from the Philadelphia area, New Jersey.
I am.
You're an Eagles fan.
I am.
Yes,
I
we
am.
Are.
Yeah, bleeding green.
Yes, we do. We even won a Super Bowl, folks. Take that. So, Deb, let folks know about RVA Works and what you guys do in the community.
Sure. Well, first of all, you know, thanks again for having me on today, Mike. You know, I think the natural place to start is that everything I do is really guided by a heart for love and service. And, you know, a few years ago, I got RVA Works up and running with a small group of people, my co-founders, and you know, it's essentially a Virginia nonprofit, which is all about helping more people become business owners. And so we work with many different people from around the greater Richmond area, and now increasingly people who are not necessarily in Richmond. And we provide opportunities to learn how to build a business. We provide people, increasingly we're starting to do more on the lending side so people can get access to capital that they need, and also helping people to invest funds when they've done well from their business.
Okay, and how long have you guys been up and running? Because I know a number of people who sing the praises for RVA Works. How long have you guys been in business, and how do people get engaged with you?
Yeah, so we started back in 2013. We were it actually started as a project of the Economic Development Authority, and we said, hey, you know, we should have a more inclusive and diverse ecosystem for entrepreneurs. And so we started as a small project, and we got the blessing of then Secretary of Commerce and Trade, and we developed a entrepreneurial strategy for the region. It was adopted by the Planning District Commission, and all of that was the genesis of forming a new nonprofit, which had not existed up to that point. And so, to answer your question directly, we started in 2014. We formed our nonprofit.
All righty. So, ladies and gentlemen, the voice you're listening to is Dale Fickett from RVA Works. So, a person has an idea. How do they make that idea come to fruition and start into the RVA Works program?
Right. Well, the first thing, as you already pointed out, Mike, is that someone needs to have an idea. So historically, we have always asked that people come to us with their idea, their vision, their passion of what they're looking to do. And so we're not an idea factory. We're not trying to tell people what to do. We're also not trying to convince someone that they should start a business. But if someone has the passion to do it and they really want to pursue it, they're serious about it, then we're there to provide them the tools so that they can build the business. And so we're always looking for, number one, you know, what is that idea? Number two, is that idea feasible? Number three, are they in a set of life circumstances where they can seriously start a new business? And if we're checking the boxes on all three, then we're looking to accept them into our program. We're in the process of taking folks in for our August cohort. So August the 20th is the deadline for the next cohort. So your timing is impeccable. Thank you.
Well, thank you. You're welcome.
And so the answer is rvaworks.org. If you go in there, you can hit the apply button, fill out the application. It's a very short application. You'll get in the queue, and then we're going to be setting up interviews later this month.
How many are typically in the cohort?
Well, we've had cohorts that have ranged in size from 6, 7, 8 people all the way up to about 20 people. And typically, we found that if we have a group that's anywhere in that range, it's productive in terms of the dialogue and the interaction. Because, and I think this is an important point, by the way, Mike, is that as an industry of support organizations for entrepreneurs, we tend to focus a lot on mentorship. And I'm all in favor of mentors. But I think we sometimes don't give enough credibility to the extent and the value of peer support. And so when people are getting that support from fellow entrepreneurs, it's incredibly valuable.
So you guys, so they're building a business, but they're also building partnerships as they're growing their business and ideas. The RVA ecosystem, as far as entrepreneurship and startups, is crowded. There are a lot of people out there doing that.
Right.
What makes Richmond such a fertile ground for the starting of businesses and the whole startup ecosystem?
Yeah, well, I would say that first, we have to take into account Richmond historically, right? So we're seeing all of this play out in terms of our streets. We're seeing a lot of social unrest happening. We're in the middle of the pandemic. We have this whole backdrop of tobacco, the Confederacy, right? And so as we look at all of that history, I think Richmond is a natural place to say, but what can we do that's a part of the solution, right? We know the problems, but what can we do that's a part of the solution? And so I think when you look at what helps in terms of providing livelihood so people can provide for themselves and their families, what's helpful in terms of alleviating poverty, creating jobs, I think Richmond is right at that intersection. And so I think that's one thing. I think, and RVA Works has played no small part, and I don't say that in a self-serving way because it's a whole group of us, but has played no small part in making that happen in terms of empowerment, inclusion, and what I call teach a man to fish sort of ministry.
So you have, so folks, the time is 1:17. We have Dale Fickett in the house from RVA Works. It's on the mic with Mike. So you have a diversity, your model is a diversity gym. So you reach all across the board. Any and everyone comes to your program. Talk a little bit about that and how that builds a better system as far as entrepreneurs and the business community goes.
Well, I think that there's a very valuable point in that Virginia itself as a state has a very vibrant economy. And historically, you know, even when we've seen times when new business formation rates nationally were fairly flat, Virginia was still doing fairly well. Now, a lot of that was concentrated around government contracting. You could, you know, think of around the Tidewater area. We can think of Northern Virginia. All of that is true. And there, and yet, when we look at Richmond, we also, with that kind of backdrop of all of that economic activity in Richmond, we also have a very vibrant culture, arts culture. There's a lot going on around the Richmond ecosystem, as you said. So we can look at a lot of different institutions that are supporting that type of entrepreneurship. And a lot of it is focused on high tech, high growth folks that want to attract venture capital. But the reality is that very small percentage of folks will get an outside equity investor. Usually it's right around 5%, less than 5%. And when we talk about the real high-end venture capital, it's less than 1%. So it's a very difficult game to play. And so, you know, what I looked at, and I started off by saying a heart for love and service, is that, you know, I look and see, you know, different people who are my sisters and brothers and say, well, what can I do that could actually be of help? And I just happen to be someone that knows some things about economics, finance, and business strategy. So what could I do that would be helpful? Well, I can help them provide a livelihood for themselves and their families so that they're strong enough that they can go and help someone else.
Folks, that is why we are here. This is a social enterprise business that society can make be better by what happens in the business community. That right there is a gold mine for the idea of helping a person make their life better and their family's life better all through teaching them how to be a business owner. So the time is 1:19, folks. We got to go away and take care of some things. Make sure you take a listen to our sponsors. We'll be back with Dale Fickett. He's going to talk a little bit more about RVA Works. And also, we know you from the Million Cups.
Right.
We got to talk a little bit about that, too, because he's how I got introduced to that. So we'll be back in a moment.
Welcome to your neighborhood wellness store. Your journey with wellness is our number one priority. We can help you navigate your journey through our cold-pressed juice bar, CBD products, health and wellness products to include hemp shea butter, relax and unwind in our Wi-Fi lounge, and more. We are located at 14822 Hull Street Road or online at yes2hl.com. Phone number 804-818-2867.
Hi, my name is Daquan Woodbury, also known as Chef PQ. The restaurant industry is going through a hard time right now. With COVID-19, a lot of things are going on, restaurants are shutting down, they might have to even close their doors for good. In the past few months, we've seen how life can change dramatically in a blink of an eye. Fortunately, I've created a system, a proven system, that allows restaurants to stay successful in this new way of life. As the owner of RVA Cafe, I would love to help you through these challenging times. Go to redindigofood.com for more information.
Hi everyone, it's Pavi Leitner, the CEO and founder of FinLit and your family's certified financial educator, dedicated to the financial success of you and your family. Are you not sure where to start with your finances? Or are you looking to sign your middle schooler up for our virtual camp? Book us at www.finlitva.com. That is www.finlitva.com. FinLit is creating a money conscious community. Hi everyone, it's Pavi Leitner.
Chris Ship here with Focus Floors, and for the month of May, we are offering a free upgrade in any Bona water-based poly for any job that gets put on our schedule. You can reach us at focushardwoodflooring.com or just check us out on Facebook or Instagram. Facebook, Focus Floors 804, Instagram 80Floors. Thank you.
Did you know embroidery is an easy, low-cost way to market your business? Let Godmama Wear LLC assist you with your custom logo embroidery needs. Whether you need shirts, hats, or yoga mats, Godmama Wear can embroider various items. Visit us online at www.godmamawear.com. That's www.godmamawear.com. Let's talk soon.
Dessert Diva RVA. Specialty boutique with specialty products, providing custom experiences. Our dessert boutique is open on the weekends. Every dessert made from scratch. We also offer date nights and event decor. Dessert Diva RVA, the official home of Party in a Box.
Oh, hello. I'm Louise Keaton from the Whistle Stop Theater Company. You're listening to On the Mic with Mike.
Every day.
At 1 p.m. Cheers.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. On the Mic with Mike. It is the premier social business enterprise show here in the Richmond area. I'm your host, Mike King, and we're here with you daily. From 1 to 2 p.m. on WJFM, that's 100.5, 92.7, FM, 820 AM. We have us with us in the house, Dale Fickett of RVA Works. We have up on deck, we have J.B. Bryant. We have Tom Childrey over in the on-deck circle. So we're keeping things moving. Dale, tell us a little bit about the idea of your involvement with 1 Million Cups.
Sure. So, Mike, 1 Million Cups is a national program of the Kauffman Foundation. It's the largest, most significant private foundation in the country serving and promoting education through research, through programs that they develop, and through political advocacy. And so we got started working with them back in 2014 to have a very strong chapter, if you like, but we call it a community of 1 Million Cups in Richmond. And the alignment with our ethos, with our mission, our passion around inclusion and diversity is right in line. And when I say diversity, a lot of people think of race, and that's true. But we're also talking about gender. We're talking about age, industry sector, education level. It's a very, very diverse community, and people are coming in to build connections with other business owners. It's not networking. It's not, you know, kind of promotions. It's really about people coming in and entrepreneurs supporting each other. They can present their business. They can also learn from the presenter, refine their own idea. When they refine that idea, a lot of times they'll develop local sales.
Ladies and gentlemen, the voice is Dale Fickett. I got to give a shout out to Ian with you. I mean,
awesome.
He's a champion.
He's awesome.
With the work that he does for you guys there. So, you know, whenever I go to the meetings, he always has a lot of things, you know, his things on point, and he handles it and moves on to the next thing. So shout out to you guys as well.
Ian Young is a great guy. I've been friends with Ian now for, since we got started, for 6 years now. And Ian is a fantastic guy.
Give him my regards. So how has COVID changed RVA Works from the business model?
Yeah, so a couple of things are happening. One is pretty much immediately we moved to an online cohort. So August will be 100% online on Zoom. We also have been moving our conversations, our weekly conversations, into Zoom meetings. So for people who are interested, they can go to meetup.com, search for RVA Works. You'll find us there. They can go ahead and find the meetups that we're doing. We're doing one on Thursday. This week, we're going to have a gentleman coming in talking about revenue share agreements and how entrepreneurs can raise capital where they're not diluting their ownership in the business. So we've moved online. 1 Million Cups as our program will get restarted as we relaunch in terms of what post-COVID looks like with VCU. That's where we hold it, on the VCU campus. And then probably the other biggest change is that, and actually it's a continuation, I should say, of developing our open trellis on the back end, which essentially is going to be a new system where people are able to pose entrepreneur questions, get answers, also apply for a small business loan. And then, as I said, we'll also be able to help people invest.
So what are the hot industries that people are talking to you about now? You're out there among people in the streets. What are people talking about starting?
Yeah, so right now, I think a lot of people are in response mode, right? So here we are in Richmond, and I already made mention of this. So COVID hits us, then we have a lot of social unrest in relation to some of the dynamics happening around the country. We see all that playing out on our streets, and then we also have this hurricane, right? So in a lot of ways, it's a perfect storm for small business owners. It's very difficult. The number one topic is conserving cash. Then we're talking about Paycheck Protection Program, the EIDL small business loans. We're talking about the Federal Reserve Main Street Lending Program. We're having a lot of conversations about capital preservation and how to remain in business. When we talk about people who are thinking about new ideas, I think we're front and center in terms of home-based business. We're thinking about what can be done for in-home services and how to do that in a smart way and in a in terms of in a sanitary way and so forth. We're also talking with folks about food businesses and what can be done, you know, with the closures of a lot of restaurants, what can be done in terms of food trucks and other delivery services. And I think probably the biggest factor there, Mike, is commercial real estate. If we look across the industry overall, commercial real estate is really under a lot of pressure right now, not just in terms of retail, but also in terms of restaurants, office space too.
Alrighty, folks, the voice is Dale Fickett from RVA Works. Dale, let folks know how they can find you and get involved. I know the cohort is getting ready to get started.
Oh, yeah, just to head on to rvaworks.org. Go in there and find the button to apply. When you apply to start up a new business, you fill out a short application form. We're taking applications now. We've had a very strong response rate. We're looking forward to interviewing folks. By the way, we're very committed to having alumni of our program involved in every aspect of our organization. We have alumni on our board of directors. We have alumni that help interview applicants who are coming into the program. We have alumni and other different small business owners helping to organize our 1 Million Cups group. So we're very committed to that. And I think anyone who comes in will find a warm welcome.
Alrighty, folks, that is Dale Fickett. I'd like to thank you for coming in. If there's ever anything, make sure you stay in touch with the program. We're here to help you get the word out. Thanks for coming in.
Okay, thank you, Mike.
All right, and go to our Eagles too. Bet it was a tough break with Doug Peterson, I heard. So, folks,
I know it.
That's two Eagles fans here. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you on the other side. We have JB Bryant, Tom Childry here, Mike King here with On the Mic with Mike, 100.5, 92.7. 8:20 a.m., the best social enterprise business show here in RVA. We'll see you on the other side.
Current news, I'm John Scott. The National Hurricane Center predicting heavy rain and more tornadoes as Isaias moves into New England this evening. Says flash flooding is possible in urban areas all along the Interstate 95 corridor. The U.S. Census Bureau cutting its schedule for data collection for a 2020 census a month short now. That decision comes as legislation that would have extended the national headcount's deadline stalls in the U.S. Senate. The Trump administration awarding more than $35 million in Justice Department grants to nonprofit organizations that provide safe housing for survivors of human trafficking. The grants being announced at a White House event today. The White House says more than 70 organizations in 33 states will share those grants. On Wall Street, the Dow ahead 84 points. The NASDAQ is up 5. This is SRN News.
I know that on those tablets Mr. Moses brought down is the commandment to not covet. But I'll confess, my neighbor and his lawnmower is making it tough. He's got this stand-behind, ride-along space shuttle that covers probably 3 times more space than my trusty old lawn boy. So, when we have who mows the fastest races, which are completely fabricated in my head, he has some impressive advantages that I just don't have. And at our Faith and Family Mortgage team, we're blessed to have a pretty special advantage of our own, and one that could be a big deal for you. Our team is lucky to be an arm of a bigger company that is a direct lender, which means our company gets to use its own money and make its own decisions within its own walls, an advantage that often allows us to get you a better rate, saving you monthly and lifelong money on a refinance or new home purchase. We are United Faith Mortgage.
United Faith Mortgage is a DBA of United Mortgage Corp, 25 Melville Park Road, Melville, New York. Licensed mortgage banker. For all licensing information, go to animalistconsumeraccess.org. Corporate Animalist number 1330. Equal housing lender. Not licensed in Alaska, Hawaii, Georgia, Massachusetts, North Dakota, South Dakota, or Utah.
Need to travel 100 miles. Would you rather walk or drive?
As a doctor and a business owner with 15 employees, I know how hard this shutdown has been on our families and our society. I took an oath to do no harm and promote safe and healthy living. That could mean encouraging patients to take better care of themselves or taking common sense precautions to protect themselves from a virus. I'm confident that the time has come to start reopening our communities. Because we know who is at low risk, we can let these individuals get back to work. We also know which groups are at highest risk and can focus our resources on protecting them. By working together, we have flattened the curve. Now it's time for Main Street to reopen.
By working together, we were able to flatten the curve, but now it's time to flatten the fear. By taking common sense precautions like social distancing, the vast majority of people under the age of 65 are at very low risk. Together, we can open America. Find out more at flattenthefear.com. Brought to you by the Job Creators Network Foundation.
Welcome to the SBA Weekly Business Tip. I am Martin Short with the U.S. Small Business Administration Virginia District Office. Although COVID-19 has presented us with an unprecedented economic period, the SBA is still here to help entrepreneurs, small businesses, and nonprofits recover. The SBA has billions of dollars in guaranteed loans available under the Economic Injury Disaster Loan and the Payroll Protection Program, or PPP. We are committed to helping all small businesses rebuild and recover. Let's continue the recovery process together. Visit us at sba.gov/coronavirus.
Does your home need a makeover? If so, refresh with quality with LA Labor and Painting, LLC. They make your home sparkle and be the envy of the community. They are masters at interior and exterior painting, drywall. They clean decks. They landscape and remove items you wish were gone. The bottom line is, they refresh with quality, provide professional service, and follow all guidelines regarding COVID-19. Call today to make your home sparkle. You can reach LA Labor by calling 804-972-8014. Call today for the On the Mic with Mike discount. When you mention the program, you'll receive 20% off of the beautification of your most prized possession. Call LA Labor and Painting today at 804-972-8014.
Thank you, attorneys Justin Lauder and Chris Gatewood at Threshold Counsel PC for sponsoring this program. They offer startup, business, and intellectual property services for innovative and growing organizations. You can find them online at threshold.cc.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jimmy Stump with Stump's Pig and Pint. We're located on the corner of 2nd Street and 119 East Lee. We specialize in slow-cooked meats, handmade sides, and homemade desserts. Stop by. Let us take great care of you. You can find us on Facebook at Stump's Pig and Pint, or you can give us a call, 804-477-3208, 804-477-3208. We look forward to taking care of you soon.
Would you like to capture a special life moment? Do you need a photographer with the ability to make that moment live on forever using COVID-19 guidelines? Please contact Pure Essence Photography today. We specialize in weddings, family events, and professional headshots. Please contact us today to get the special On the Mic with Mike discount. We can be reached at 804-926-8101 or by visiting us at pureessencecaptured.com.
My name is Isabella, and you're listening to Mike King Biz Hubby. That's my skin.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. It is the premier social business enterprise show in the Richmond area. I'm Mike King, your host. We're here with you every day from 1 to 2 p.m. on WJFN. That's 100.5, 92.7 FM, 820 AM. This is a business show, and if you have a business show and you want to talk about business topics, you bring in the one and only J.B. Bryant. J.B., welcome to the program.
It would be believable if I was the first person you ever invited to your show, but I'm way down on your list. I'm
but you know what? You started on me. You started me in radio. You were the first person.
So, but that's how it happens. I started Oprah too. Look what happened.
You kind
Look
of blow
what happened.
Up.
She's never had me on yet either.
You know what? From back in the Lee days, when I didn't know who you were with the microphone, and when you said, "Don't hand me the mic because this is what happened." That's what right. happened, folks.
Move over, Mike.
So we are happy to have you here on the program. Everyone talks. So give Thank folks you. A little bit about your background. Most people know. But then we're going to talk about some of the financial things, what's going on in the world today during Great. The COVID and this crisis and what you do with Afroeconomics. Great. But then we're going to talk about speech and some of the topics that you had put out there and how you stood your ground. So we're going to sort of leave that for a tease. Let us know who J.B. Great. Bryan and your organization is.
Well, I started J.B. Bryan Financial Group, a registered investment advisory firm, in 1995 after leaving a regional investment firm in Virginia, Richmond, Virginia. And my firm, I created a trademark financial planning program called Afroeconomics based on 10 strategic principles of managing your life. You know, it says Afroeconomics, but it's really just shows how important money is. So as an investment advisory firm, we are based on the principle of always looking out for the best interest of the client. And we're not attached to products. My licenses are actually attached to making sure that I don't have conflicts of interest and that I'm always looking out for the best interest of the person who hired me.
All righty, folks, you're listening to J.B. Bryan. So you have offices here, but you really blazed some trails as far as financial goes. Tell a little bit about
Thank
your
you.
History and how you got into this point.
Yes,
and plus
indeed.
Your immediate TV, you're a personality. You're always on TV. If it's Virginia this morning.
If you're on CBS, you see me. That's right.
That
you
is,
be
so
on the right
they
channel.
Might as well call that the J.B. Bryan show. So.
I wish indeed, but I really appreciate the opportunity as they've been good to me. And it gives me an opportunity to focus on, I'm working on a topic now for them, indeed, because these are special financial times. And the firm itself, it's about like keeping up with what's going on in the marketplace. Like tomorrow night, I'm doing a workshop on how is the market, the NASDAQ specifically, reaching new record highs, while there's people sitting at home waiting for new stimulus checks and, you know, and knowing that their job will never come back to them. They've got to find another industry, another place to work, you know, and they're waiting on, will I get another $600 to supplement my state unemployment? So at the same time as people are in financial crisis, you have people that are celebrating, and that's my job to try to show you both sides, but hopefully keep you on the side of celebrating while we manage through this. There is no track record. There's no history of this. But I have always told people we need to always have an emergency fund, even though on average going into this pandemic, people couldn't come up with like $400 for an emergency. And so we definitely, I think that the importance of wise counsel, not a financial salesperson, but the importance of an investment advisor on your team, it really shows up during times like this. I've been helping people looking at their tax returns, making sure they don't have errors in it. I've been stopping senior financial exploitation that is on the rise. Been helping people from cybersecurity, as well as I have my own investment portfolios, but they're based on your specific risk tolerance and your financial goals, how much time you have and what you're trying to accomplish. I don't have just one portfolio, and my portfolios focus on minimum expenses, and they're all, I generally use ETFs. So you're saving a lot of money just on escaping internal expenses or keeping them to the minimum and outperforming the benchmark for their categories in most cases.
All righty, folks, that is J.B. Bryant. So, J.B., let people know how they can get information for the financial services and help that you provide.
Sure. My free workshop information, it's at J.B. Bryan, J-B-B-R-Y-A-N.com, or afroeconomics.com. The events calendar is at both places. Sign up for one of the free workshops. I have them all the time. I even do a Sunday at Sunrise that's kind of biblically financial-based topic for us to discuss. So it's all there. Just make sure you take advantage.
It is. So, and you also do a ton of work in the community, too. Last time I saw you were doing, shout out to Lamit, the guy.
Yes.
Because you were doing the, I guess, the
fundraiser
the hosting for her.
Yeah, that was great. And I was able to sponsor that event, too, to help her do that fundraiser. And then she said, that's not enough. I want you free labor, some free labor out of you, too.
And next thing I know, JB's working the microphone. Okay, so here, let's talk a little bit about, I'm perusing Facebook, and I see a post. And the post, and your post was talking about at least taking a listen to Kanye West for president.
Yeah.
At least listening to, or the possibility of there. And next thing, all types of incoming fire is coming your way.
Yes, indeed. I made some friends and lost some friends.
Okay.
My point on the post about Kanye West was about freedom, about putting yourself politically in a state of freedom where you can decide to run. And I think that people are not involved in the political system, especially black men, because they don't really feel attached to it. They don't think that it includes them. So how better for you to feel included than by running for something? And that was my point that, I mean, the Democratic Party has done a good job of saying that they want a black woman as VP. That's great, but they're saying that because, what, the black woman is more likely to vote than the black man. So instead of asking the question of why black men aren't activated, they just said, forget about them. We'll just get a black woman. That's cool. I'm a black woman. I love that. But I think that the black man, his mission, his thoughts, like I even saw one post where it said that we need to have a black woman vice president because of the environment that we have in the George Floyd. So what you're saying is that we have a black man problem that needs to be solved by a black woman? I mean, so there's also black men that party could be looking at, considering. But outside of that, I'm excited that Kanye West felt, I know that people will oppose this, but I still feel that I should do this. And the so I just feel that we should be about freedom and opening up the political system so that people can participate. Because I remember as a young person in the city of Richmond, I was owning property in the city of Richmond and everything, and I said to one of the senators, I said, I want to run for city council. And he said, well, I can't support you because I have to support my friend that was, you know, about 30 years older than me, and that was his friend. And I said, but, you know, you can't consider anyone else? And he said, no, I have to support him. Well, the year didn't end up going very well for that friend that he supported. It was, but it just lets you know how closed out young people, black people, feel in this political environment that we have. So I just feel like Kanye West should receive accolades for at least trying. I mean, he's a billionaire. If he wants to spend $1 billion on a political dream, he should have. We should encourage him to do that. That doesn't mean you have to vote for him. I don't think he's looking for your acceptance. I think he just wants to present his message.
Alrighty, folks, the voice you're listening to is J.B. Bryant, financial guru. So now here, people who had known you, and you knew a lot of people, and they looked at you as a business person. Were you shocked with the level of fire that you took in regarding your ideas?
No. I mean, I was excited about the passion that people feel about putting down the black man. And I felt that that's why I didn't delete most of the comments. Like, as long as they were talking about ugly things about Kanye, I felt that black men needed to see how people really feel, especially the black men that were talking about him as a black man. Like, there was one black man that said, he's not even black. He doesn't think he's black because he's rich. He thinks he's white, you know. And, you know, that's really frightening, you know, the thoughts that we have. And I also put a follow-up post. If you want to see how we've been socialized and how we see ourselves and each other because of socialization, look at the comments. And then also the comments about mental health, you know, that people were diagnosing, you know, and saying because he has a mental illness, he shouldn't be running for president. But that will be the same people who will say you should feel empathy for people when they commit suicide or they have a mental disorder. So does a mental disability totally mean a person who has suffered from depression should never be able to run for president, or bipolar, or, you know, what's our criteria there? You know, so I guess we'll add that to the list, that they must show their tax return and they must also tell you a psychological report. You know,
that is true. So you had said, I saw one of the posts that you had said where you had sort of the same idea about Obama and people sort of were looking at you. Talk a little bit about that real quick.
Yeah, I remember when Obama said, you know, I want to be the Democratic nominee. I didn't know anyone. A whole bunch of these people who now act like they're Obama's best friend and you're the greatest and this and that were the same people who were putting him down. Like, why would he do this? He's never going to get it. America's not ready for a black man president. Like, oh, he'll never win. Hillary's going to get that, you know, the party appointment and everything. And I said, no, he's going to, you know, laughing me off. But at least they weren't as, you know, as mean. I don't know if it's because we're going through the pandemic, you know, where they felt this sense of like attack, you know, they more on Obama, they more attacked me and then said that he didn't have any experience and he's a community organizer and he doesn't know anything about what he's doing and, you know, that he should wait to the next go round and stuff like that. But I just believe in the impossible. And I just believe that if you're not doing something that is stretching you, that's frightening you, then you're really not accomplishing anything in life. And if you look at anyone who's ever accomplished anything, like when I started my own investment advisory firm, they said, no way, black people won't support you, black people don't have any money, they don't, you know, and here I am in going into 30 years, like, you know, more than 25 years of being in my own firm. And that is, you know, if I had given into that, all of the millions of dollars that I have helped people, you know, manage and build families and, you know, set up generational wealth that, you know, would have been lost if I had bought into that. I think that everybody with a dream has to cancel out, because a lot of times the people that love you and care about you will give you the worst advice.
That is true.
Because they don't want to see you lose. They don't want to see you hurt. They don't want to see things not work out for you. But that's where you gain strength. And it's not easy. You know, it's not easy. But we're not doing it for easy. You can't build muscle unless you lift weight. That's the way I see it.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is J.B. Bryant. J.B., one last time, let folks know how they can find you and the information that you offer.
Definitely. Google me, baby.
I hear you.
JB Bryan, or Google afroeconomics.com, jbbryan.com, 1-844-JB-Bryan. I'm just a phone call away. I'm in Richmond, D.C., and New York locations. But, hey, now cyber takes me everywhere. So we can Zoom, have a Zoom meeting, and get things done.
All righty. Thanks for coming on the program. I'll be on the lookout. And I wanted you to come on and talk about your financial stuff, but also the freedom of speech and how you defend it. Yeah. I appreciate that.
Thank you. I appreciate you.
All right. Thanks, JB. Take care. Ladies and gentlemen, that is J.B. Bryan. You can catch her everywhere, including on Virginia This Morning. We have to go away and take care of some bills. On the way, when we come back on the other side, we have Tom Childrey, the new show sponsor for On the Mic with Mike, and talk a little bit about what he does and appreciate him for being the show sponsor. We'll talk to you on the other side. Thanks.
My name is Kashfia Rashid, but you can call me Cash. I am an accounting strategist. I help business owners set up and maintain a customized automated bookkeeping system. You see, accounting is the language of business, but not all small business owners are fluent. I translate accounting into English, empowering my clients to work in their zones of genius with comprehensive reports that easily show them the opportunities they can take advantage of to grow their business. I use automation to take care of the daily transaction processing, freeing up time, energy, and resources, all while restoring peace and sanity. All companies need a little cash. You can find out more on my website, www.cashthebookkeeper.com.
Hi, this is Melanie Staples. I'm from Waterfall Salon and Massage Med Spa with two beautiful locations in Glen Allen and Bon Air, Virginia. Our business is growing and we're looking for spa professionals just like you. So if you're a mature person that would like to get some extra cash and be a front desk receptionist, or if you are a spa professional who has expertise in waxing or eyelash extensions, or as a master esthetician, we would love to have you. If you are a massage therapist and would love to get the experience of working with a master medical massage practitioner, Nasser Staples, Waterfalls is the place to be. Please give us a call at 804-644-4002 or visit us online and to submit your application. We look forward to meeting you. Thank you.
Hi, Chef Michelle here of Mama Chef Cafe, home of the Soul Rolls, located at 10811 Hull Street Road. Give us a call at 804-912-1644 or order online at mamachef.com. Ask about our off-site catering options as well as our online ordering through Grubhub, Uber Eats, and DoorDash. Follow us on all social media at Mama Chef Cafe. That's Mama Chef's, Soul, south of the James. Mention Mike on the mic and get a free dessert on us. Special rules apply.
Since the very beginning, CEO Magazine has been empowering women to be the chief executive of their lives. Sharon's dream was to create this lifestyle publication that helped women manage the hustle and bustle of their everyday. From hair to makeup and photo shoots to the look of your brand and even messaging, whether you are being featured on our front cover or inside our magazine, or simply partner with us, our team of people go to work for you. You sign up for a complete experience. You can share your story on our social media platform or come and network at one of our events. As CEO, we want to see you thrive, innovate, and create the life that you love.
Before and after, the salon has been active in the Richmond, Virginia community, providing hairstyling services for over 10 years. Before and After is located in downtown Richmond at 1917 West Carey Street. Specializing in weaves, extensions, and growing healthy hair, Before and After provides a full suite of hair care services. Expert stylists Michelle Smith and Alicia Clark are well trained to meet your styling needs at Before and After the salon.
Hi, this is Sylvia Farbstein, and I am on the air with Mike King. He is widening the lens of humanity, and I'm so happy to be a part of his journey.
Gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. I'd like to thank J.B. Bryant for coming in and talking to us about freedom of speech as well as Afroeconomics. You can follow her anywhere at J.B. Bryant. You'll be able to find it. But up next, we have in the studio, in the house with us, we have Tom Childry, who is the new show sponsor for On the Mic with Mike. Tom, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Mike. Glad to be here.
Okay, could you... There we go. The magic of radio.
Got all the tools.
So, Tom, tell us a little about the services that you provide, and also we talked when you were here before about your ties to the community. From a business standpoint, what is it that you can help business owners with some of the programs? Like you have another chip in, you have some other things. Talk a little bit about what you do and how you can help.
Okay. So, again, Mike, thank you. Tom Childrey, the credit card guy. With Beyond, and I simply believe it shouldn't be confusing or expensive for businesses to accept payments, credit cards, debit cards, that type of thing. And as a social enterprise business advocate, my mission is to get business owners paid faster with fair rates, helping them grow their business in the greater Richmond area. So we have some programs, as you mentioned, Mike, it's called Chip In. You know, we all know that we have to socially give back and help the community, because the money we make and spend here goes into other businesses, and that's what drives a successful economy. So the chip-in program was designed to help nonprofits. So as they say now, there's an app for everything. Well, we have a great app that consumers can put the app on their phone and pick their favorite nonprofit, and then go to their favorite restaurant, and that restaurant would agree that, you know, if you come and spend $25, we'll donate $2.50 to, if your favorite charity was the SPCA. And that helps the business be able to drive revenue so they can afford to make those donations. And it also helps donors and customers feel like I'm being socially active, I'm helping my nonprofit that I care about. And there's many nonprofits in the area, and all of them can benefit from that. Some people have multiple nonprofits that they donate to, and some, you know, have a favorite one. And we're helping businesses support the community, and that's the chip-in program, which is one of the many programs that we offer.
All righty, folks, so Tom Childrey here. He's going to be back in studio with us in about a week or so. So let folks know very quickly what you're looking for. You can help a restaurant owner. You can help a regular business owner. You got about 30 seconds with that.
Okay. We work with successful business owners, or those businesses that need a push-up. We help you drive new customers, and we help you reduce the cost of accepting payments from those customers. I can be reached at area code 804-503-8472. Again, 804-503-8472. And my website is, of course, www.getbeyond.com. Getbeyond.com.
All righty, folks. Tom
Childrey.
Pleasure
talking to you. Thank
you. Tom Childrey there. Show sponsor Mike King here. We're going to check tomorrow. We'd like to welcome in. It's SBA Wednesday. We'll also have Skyler Washington, young person voice on the street, and Mush King talking about podcasting. Mike King here. We'll talk to you tomorrow. Thanks for tuning in.
To WJFN Goochland, WJFN Chester.
Hour from townhall.com. I'm John Scott. Tropical storm Isaias is spawning tornadoes and dumping rain during an inland march.